We all know games like Mario, Zelda, Contra, and of course Ninja Gaiden. But there are many interesting games on the NES. Some of these games may be a bit obscure, but they're certainly worth your time. So join me today as we take a look at one of the NES's many hidden gems. Nintendo has always been a very Japan-centric company. They of course care about the foreign market just as much as any publisher would, but when it comes to designing games, they rarely focus on appealing to the West. This is what makes Star Tropic so special, as it is one of the few first-party Nintendo games developed specifically to appeal to a Western audience. This is more obvious when you look at the game's protagonist, Mike. Mike is a 15-year-old boy from Seattle who plays baseball and fights using a yo-yo. Another interesting detail is that the names of the villages in the game all end with the word cola. You have Coro Cola, Mira Cola, Sea Cola, and Bell Cola. This video is sponsored by Cola. Try the new Medi Cola or Coro Cola flavors today. No, this video is not sponsored anyway. I'll happily accept your money though. Call me. As you probably already noticed, Star Tropics has a lot in common with the first Legend of Zelda game. The fast selection screen is almost identical. Star Tropics also uses the same life system as Zelda, hearts. These hearts even use the same sprites. What separates the two games is that Star Tropics is entirely linear and chapter-based, while The Legend of Zelda is more open on how to approach the game. The setting of Star Tropics is also completely different from Zelda, as Star Tropics is based, as the name suggests, in the tropics of the Coral Sea, while Zelda has a more traditional fantasy setting. The chapter-based nature of Star Tropics allows the game to focus more tightly on its storytelling than most NES games, and while I'm not going to spoil the story for you, I will tell you a bit about the game's backstory. The story begins when our protagonist Mike receives a letter from his uncle Steve, who is a famous archaeologist. The letter asks Mike to visit him during his summer vacation in the village Coro Cola. Mike has never met his uncle before, but he's excited to visit him. But when Mike arrives at Coro Cola, he quickly discovers that Uncle Steve has been kidnapped. Armed with nothing but a yo-yo, he quickly sets off to rescue his uncle. The story of Star Tropics is mainly communicated to you through dialogue with various characters. The art used in those scenes is incredibly impressive for its time. The art used in the overworld in which you travel from location to location is a lot less impressive, however. Both the sprites and backgrounds of those sections of the game are small and undetailed. The graphics used for the dungeons and action scenes, however, are a lot better. And these sections of the game is where you'll be spending most of your actual playtime, so the fact that the enemies look not only creative, but have a high quality sprite really make the game shine in the action focus segments. The backgrounds used in these action segments of Star Tropics are not as impressive as the design used for the enemies. All of the dungeons, except those that are in Chapter 7 and 8, use the same background, that of a cave. And while palette swaps help give some variety, I don't think it does enough. The rooms inside these dungeons are laid out in a grid-like manner, and movement is along this grid. This leads to my biggest problem with Star Tropics, the controls. Mike is unable to leave the grid structure of the rooms and is forced to move along with the grid. This means that movement feels very unresponsive, as you must move to the next square in the grid before you can change directions. There is also a jump button. The jump is used to both dodge enemy attacks and jump from platform to platform. However, if you are not jumping to a platform or over an obstacle, you can only jump in place. This combined with the grid layout often forces you to take damage that the better control system would have allowed you to avoid. I eventually got used to the controls, which made these problems less of a factor, but I would still have preferred a smoother control system, more akin to Legends of Zelda. Let's discuss the combat a bit. It is after all the thing you'll be doing for most of the game. Mike can attack in the same four directions he can move, up, down, left and right. Attacking is done with a yo-yo or one of the sub-weapons. The yo-yo has a small range at the start, but by the end of the game your yo-yo is able to shoot projectiles. The sub-weapons can be found in the dungeons and have a limited amount of uses. The sub-weapons are all very different in the use and are fairly powerful. My favorite sub-weapon is the shuriken, which when thrown splits up into two shurikens, which each go into a different direction. You really have to take a different approach to combat when using the shurikens, or any sub-weapon for that matter, which really helps vary the combat. Gameplay outside of the dungeons is relatively simple and is best compared to Final Fantasy. You simply walk from place to place and talk to NPCs and solve mazes along the way. The soundtrack of Star Tropics, which has been playing in the background, is of a very high quality for the NES. It has a very upbeat and energetic vibe to it too. The soundtrack is actually very large for an NES game, but you will be listening to the same two tracks for most of the game, the overworld theme and the dungeon theme. It is a good thing then that both overworld and dungeon themes are some of the best songs in the game. A really cool thing that Star Tropics does is that the letter Mike received from his uncle is actually included in the game box. But the letter does more than just provide you with some backstory, because at the end of Chapter 4, the assistant of Uncle Steve, who you rescue from a whale, tells you that you have to dip the letter in water to discover a hidden code. Luckily, the Virtual Console release of Star Tropics features a button you can press when you pause the game. When you do so, it shows a little animation of a letter being dipped into water and shows you the code. Star Tropics is a really good game for the NES, but the problems I had with the controls made some parts of the game frustrating for me. If you think you can get over those control issues, then I definitely recommend you try out the game.